And now we will learn the last type of vendor and payable transaction that you need to know about. Prepayments, which means advance payments to vendors for products and services that we will receive in the future. There are different situations that would require us to pay a vendor before we get the product or the service that we're paying for. And therefore, there are different methods or different ways to record these prepayments into QuickBooks. The method that I am showing you in this particular video is called the check to accounts payable method. The good side about this method is that the vendor's balance is always correct and your vendor records are correct to the last detail at any given moment. So if your priority is making sure that your vendor records are correct, this is the method that you should use. However, there are two downsides to this method. The first bad thing about this method is that total accounts payable in the trial balance is not accurate. That's because the vendor that you pay in advance will have a negative balance, and that will offset the total accounts payable, and you will not know the total money that you owe to all the other vendors. The other downside to this particular method is that there is no account in the chart of accounts or the trial balance showing total prepaid expenses or all the money that you paid in advance for services and products that you're waiting to receive. If your chart of accounts and your trial balance is more important to you than your vendor records, then I suggest you do the method that will be shown in the video that will follow this one. For example, on May 14th, we paid Office Max $500 in advance for three future deliveries of supplies, and we paid them with check number 1661. Well, what's going to happen if we record this transaction under the method we're using? Cash will go down because we just paid a vendor. Accounts payable will actually go down because when you pay a vendor, accounts payable decreases, and that particular vendor's balance will go negative. The individual vendor's balance will be correct, and if you look at the vendor reports, like the vendor balance detail or the unpaid bill, it will show the correct amount for that vendor. So let's go back to the transaction and see how to record it. From the main menu, click Banking, write a check. Now, the money is coming from the bank account. Okay, and it's going to accounts payable. So the cash in bank with where the money is coming from should be the account in the top of the window, and accounts payable should be the account on the bottom of the window. It was check number 1661. The date was back on May 14th. And the money amount is $500, and the vendor was Office Max. So now we have all the information we need when we actually pay for the deliveries in advance. Now you have to make strong use of the memo field, because all the other relevant information can only go in the memo field. In advance payment for three deliveries of Office supplies, and you could put any other detail you want, including the expected delivery date. Now, when you click save and close, you can double check your trial balance to see that this was the very last transaction. Here it is, May 14th, the very last transaction recorded in cash and bank, and that you can see it brings cash and bank down by $500. Maybe you can't see it. Brings cash and bank down by $500. And you could also see, if you double-click account payable, that this very same transaction, check number 1661, brings down account payable on May 14th with the memo in advance payment, and it's a debit to account payable of $500. But the most important thing is looking at the vendor reports. When you look at the Office Max report, unpaid bills shows a negative $500. If it's a negative unpaid bill, it means they owe us. And if it's on the unpaid bill report, it means it's still owed and still open. Now, here's where the interesting part comes in. May 16th received the first supply delivery from Office Max. We received $200 worth of supplies, and they sent us a paid bill with this bill number. Well, when you actually receive the product or service that you paid in advance for, there are two steps. First, enter the bill normally, the way you would whether it was a paid bill or not. Secondly, use the Pay Bills window to apply the in-advance payment credit that we recorded on May 14th. Apply that to the bill you just entered. Then the vendor records will be perfect and correct. Now, if you record it that way, supplies will go up because we physically received $200 more of supplies, and accounts payable will go up because we just received from a vendor. The vendor balance will be correct, and the reports will be accurate. So let's go back to those steps, and let's see how to record it. From the main menu, click Vendor, Enter Bill. Choose Office Max, the vendor. The date that we received the merchandise with the bill is the 16th, and it's 87876. The amount of the bill is the amount that we physically received of office supplies, and the expense, what we physically received, is supplies. So this is the way we would enter the bill, whether the bill was a paid bill or not. Soon as we click Save and Close, we can open the unpaid bills detail, and we can see that Office Max now has the correct balance of owing us $300 in future supplies. And we can see that the reason why they owe us is that we paid them $500 on May 14th, and then they delivered the merchandise with a bill on May 16th. So this is what the unpaid bills would look like. The vendor balance detail, same thing. The balance was $500, they delivered $200, and now they only owe us $300 worth of supplies. Now, what's step two? Step two is go to the pay bills window and set the bill and the check together, so that they cancel each other out and the unpaid bill report looks appropriate. From the main menu, click Vendor, Pay Bills. Make sure you choose Office Max. Notice there's only one bill, and QuickBooks doesn't yet know it's paid, but we're going to tell it now. If you only click on the row, you're not able to click Set Credit. You have to actually click in the box to be able to get the Set Credit button. Now, you only have one transaction for Office Max that's listed as a credit because we only paid Office Max once. So QuickBooks knows that this check number 1661 is a $500 credit against Office Max account. Since it's the only credit on the list, QuickBooks automatically checked it. So we're applying this $500 to the $200 payment. We click Done, and we notice the amount to pay goes down to zero. When we click Pay Selected Bill and click Done for the pop-up, now when you look at the unpaid bill report, it is perfectly accurate, and the only thing that it shows is a remaining $300 unpaid by Office Max to us for the supplies we will receive in the future.